a very warm welcome to WsCube Tech. So guys, in our previous session, we have covered that what is iteration in NumPy arrays, how we can iterate NumPy arrays basically. In our today's session, we'll be talking about what is copy versus view. That means we'll be understanding the difference between the copy function and the view function inside our NumPy arrays and how they differ from each other. So first of all, we'll talk about that the main difference between copy and the view of an array is that the copy is a new array. For example, if you have an array over here, let's say you have 1, 2, 3, 4. The copy will be what? The copy will be the exact copy of this array, while at the same time the view will be the view of the original array. Now let's understand the difference between what is the copy of the array and what is the view of the array. So to understand the example, I'll be giving you a small example. Let's say I have a phone over here. We have this as phone 1 and this one as a copy of phone 1. Okay, now this phone is of Nokia, let's say. And again, this phone is of Nokia. So it's a copy. Basically, it's a copy. Now, what will happen? Now, the copy function over here says that the second phone is the copy of our first phone. That means that if I'll open, let's say, WhatsApp over here. So it doesn't matter if I'm opening WhatsApp, I can open Instagram over here as well. So whatever is happening in this array will not make any difference in our this array. That means whatever is happening, whatever function we are doing in our phone number 1 will not affect our phone number 2. That is the copy of the phone. While at the same time, if I talk about this phone, so I have, let's say, phone 1 again, okay, and this is again of Nokia, and I have created its view over here. For view again, I'll be creating another phone. Just ignore my drawing, and this phone is also of Nokia. Now, what is the concept of view over here says that, let's say, if you have opened WhatsApp over here, in this phone also WhatsApp will get open, or in this phone, if you have opened Snapchat, in this phone also the Snapchat will get open. So basically, copy over here says that it does not own the data from where it has been copied, while view says that it owns the data. Any changes made in the view will affect in the original data, and any changes made in the original data will affect our view, while at the same time any changes made in our original data over here will not affect the copy, and or any changes made in our copy will not affect the original data. This is what our copy and view is. Now let's understand it with the help of example in our PyCharm. So as I said that the copy owns the data, and any changes made to the copy will not affect the original data, and any changes made to the original array will not affect the copy. While if I talk about the view over here, view does not own the data, and any changes made to the view will affect the original data. That means it will affect the original array, and any change made in the original array will also affect the view. Now let's have a look on an example that we can do in our PyCharm to understand the difference between copy and view. So to understand the difference in between both of them, first of all, let's import NumPy. So I'll be importing NumPy, as it says in import, it should be import NumPy as NP. Once we have imported NumPy as NP, first of all, let's create an array over here. For creating an array, I'll be writing arr is equals to np.array, and inside this I'll pass a list. Say this is my list. Okay, I want to create a copy of it. To create a copy of it, what I'll be doing, I'll be creating cc is equals to np.copy. Whose copy we need to create? We need to create the copy of arr. Let's print both of them. So I'll be printing. Now here the original one is, so I'll be writing original, and I'll put a colon. The original one is arr, and the copy, print copy of it is comma c. Let's run and see what output we'll receive. So you can see over here we have 26281 and 26281 on in both of them. That means the copy has been created. Now the concept over here says that any changes made in the original will not affect in the copy. So let's make some changes over here. Now I'm saying that on, let's say inside our arr, on index number 2, that is 0, 1 and 2, on index number 2 the value should be 7. So on index number 2 the value should be 7. Now let's run and see what output we'll get. So as soon as I run it, you can now see in the original the changes has been made, that inside this on number 2 we have 7, while at the same time on index number 2 in the copy it is still the same which was there previously. So any changes that is made inside the original is not affecting in the copy. While now let's talk about the view over here. So I'll put this data inside the comment. Again, I'll create an array over here, or we can use the similar array. So I'll just copy this from here and paste it here. Okay. Again, I'll create a view of it. To create a view of it, I'll be writing v is equals to np.view. So after creating the array, we need to create a view over here. For creating a view, we'll be writing arr.view. And here, if I print the original, so the original one is our arr. So I'll be writing original, and I'll put arr here. While at the same time, I'll be writing print. And here inside the view, we will be writing comma v. Okay, let's run and see what output we will receive. Once we run it, we'll be getting 26281 and 26281 in the original, and in the view, the both the data are same. Now let's make changes over here. So I'll be making the exact same changes over here. I'll copy this data and paste it over here. Let's run and see what output we will get now. So you can now see that the changes that has been made inside the original is also reflecting in our view. So let me just uncomment the previous data as well and run all of them all together. So you will now see the difference in the copy. Whatever changes is made inside the original, it is not affecting the copy. While at the same time, whatever changes has been made inside the original, it is affecting the view. That simply tells us the copy owns the data while view does not own the data which is there in original. So any changes made in the original will affect the original, and any changes made in the view will affect the original as well. While at the same time, if I talk about the copy, any changes made in the copy will not affect the original, and any changes made in the original will not affect the copy. So guys, this was the major difference between the copy and the view functions over here. I hope you guys have no doubts and no questions. In our next session, we'll be talking about split arrays. So stay connected, guys, and I'll see you in the next session. Thank you.